In this video, the development of interatrial septum will be discussed. The interatrial septum is the structure that divides the primitive atrium into the right and left atrial chambers. By the third week of embryo development, the two endocardial tubes fuses to form the heart tube. It has arterial and venous end. The arterial end is called truncus arteriosus and the venous end is called sinus venosus. Between them are bulbous cordis, primitive ventricle and the primitive atrium. The canal between the primitive atrium and ventricle is called atrioventricular canal. Endocardial or atrioventricular cushions develop at the anterior and posterior part of the AV canal. It then fuses to form the septum intermedium. The septum intermedium divides the atrioventricular canal into two channels, the future right and the future left atrioventricular orifices. Now let's draw the primitive atrium and ventricle separately for better understanding. By the fifth week of embryo development, a thin septum called septum primum begins to develop from the roof of the primitive atrium. It extends towards the septum intermedium or the endocardial cushions. The gap between the septum primum and the septum intermedium is called the ostium primum, that is the first formed opening. This ostium primum maintains the right to left flow of blood in the fetal heart, which is essential for the fetal life. As discussed in the fetal circulation video. The link to the fetal circulation video is given in the description. As the septum primum fuses with the septum intermedium, the upper part of the septum primum undergoes apoptosis and it develops fenestrations. And these fenestrations joins to form the second opening in the septum primum called the ostium secundum. This opening is essential for the right to left shunt for the reasons mentioned above. In the meantime, to the right of the septum primum, a thick septum called the septum secundum starts to develop at the root of the atrium. It extends downward to cover the ostium secundum of the septum primum. The septum secundum stops growing at the end of the seventh week of gestation, leaving a posterior and inferior gap. So now the communication between the right and the left atrium becomes oblique and it's called foramen ovale. Now the foramen ovale maintains the right to left shunt in the fetal heart. The foramen ovale acts as a one-way valve. The septum primum lies behind the opening in the septum secundum, allowing the blood to move from the right atrium to the left atrium by a pressure gradient. And it limits backflow by the septum primum being forced against the septum secundum by higher left atrial pressure. After birth, the lung starts to function. The right atrial pressure falls and the left atrial pressure increases. This causes the flap valve septum primum to fuse with the septum secundum and also closes the opening in the septum secundum, thus obliterating the foramen ovale. This creates a morphologic and physiologic separation of the atria. When seen from the right atrium, the septum primum, which closes the opening in the septum secundum, looks like a depression in the interatrial septum. This depression is called the fossa ovalis. The septum secundum, which surrounds the fossa ovalis, is called limbus fossa ovalis. The lack of fusion between the flap valve ostium primum and septum secundum results in patent foramen ovale or PFO. Now let's discuss some of the defects in the interatrial septum. When the septum primum fails to fuse with the endocardial cushions or the septum intermedium, the ostium primum atrial septal defect is formed. When there is excessive apoptosis and reabsorption of septum primum, or when there is insufficient formation of septum secundum, the ostium secundum atrial septal defect is formed. It should be noted that ostium secundum ASD are direct communication between the two atria, whereas a PFO is a tunnel of variable width and length between the two atria. Let's complete the video here. Hope it was useful. See you soon in the next video.